Namaste everyone. Welcome to Wave Optics class. Hope you are doing well. All of you are fine with the good health and cheering daily life, right? So we will see how are the fringes distributed and how is this formula, fringe width, what we have derived already, on what factors does it depend? And depending on some problems. So when you solve the problems, automatically you will come to know on what factors beta depends. Of course, the formula itself says that fringe width, that is distance between two successive bright fringes. It cannot be a bright fringe here and a bright fringe far away. The distance between two successive bright fringes and the two successive dark fringes, that is called beta, it is directly proportional to lambda. What do you mean by beta is directly proportional to lambda? Suppose you have used blue light, its wavelength is less. Then blue fringes may be closer and closer. Suppose you had used red light here, then the red fringes may be far away and far away. And it also depends on the capital D, that is distance between the screen and the sources, and small d, the distance between the sources. If you want to increase the fringe width beta, then use a larger wavelength, larger distance between the sources and screen, and a lesser distance between the sources. So decrease the distance between the sources, then beta will increase. Because if you have well separated fringes, then you can see it clearly. Otherwise, they get overlapped. If the fringes are very, very, very close, you can't see them separately. Okay, moving on to the next one. So distance of the nth bright fringe. You know that yesterday we have seen this. This is just a recap. If this is the central bright fringe and this is the dark one, next bright. So any bright fringe, nth bright fringe is at a distance of n beta, because second bright fringe is at 2 beta, third bright fringe is at 3 beta, and first dark fringe is at half beta, then 1.5 beta for the second bright fringe. For the third bright fringe, 2.5 beta, because half plus 1 plus 2. So 2.5, because first dark fringe is at half beta, then 1 beta, 2 beta, and so on. So fourth bright fringe is at 3.5 beta. So if you want to know whichever they be the number of the fourth dark fringe is at 3.5 beta, whichever be the number of the dark fringe, its distance is half less. That means n minus half beta. That's what you have to remember. For nth bright fringe, n beta. For nth dark fringe, n minus half beta. Okay, we will move on. And one more thing is, this is what I have explained. Fringe width depends on the wavelength. If you switch on blue light here, you will get blue bright, blue dark, blue bright, dark, blue bright, like this. But blue bright and bright distances are lesser because wavelength of blue light is less. Suppose you switch on in the same apparatus a red light, then the red fringes, red bright, dark, they are far away. So red fringes are far away, they are separated by a larger distance, whereas in the same apparatus, if you put blue light, then their fringes will be closer and closer. So beta depends on lambda wavelength. So shall we move on to the problems? We will solve four problems today, and then you will understand the fringe interference much more clearly. Okay. In Young's double slit experiment, I will send you these problems. Don't keep on writing them. I will give you the PDF format of this. In Young's double slit experiment, even the solutions, you keep on scribbling it now. So go and get a paper and pen quickly. Quickly go and get a paper and pen because you need it. As I explain, you scribble it once. Then otherwise, there is no use. You have to do this because I have told already, every problem in this will be definitely asked for the final exam. Either problem or derivation of beta. 100% out of the two, you will get one. Either derivation or problem. You see, continuously I have selected some questions from the question papers. From continuous years they have been asked. This is one question asked in, I don't remember the year, but this is asked from the previous year question paper. In Young's double slit experiment, the slits are separated by 0.28 millimeter. So you got small d, right? Small d is 0.28 into milli. Milli means 10 to the power minus 3 meter. And a screen is placed at a distance of 1.4 meter away from the slits, capital D. Screen is placed 1.4 meter away from the slits. The distance between the central bright fringe and the fifth dark fringe, they have not given beta directly. They are trying to hide beta. Distance between two successive bright fringes is beta. But here the distance from the central bright fringe and the fifth dark fringe, that means 4.5 beta. Remember, n minus half beta, right? because the first dark fringe is itself has half beta. Second dark fringe, 1.5 beta. This is the fifth dark fringe, 4.5 beta. So 4.5 beta is 1.35 centimeter. Calculate the wavelength of light used. Also find the fringe width if the screen is moved 0.4 meter towards the slits. Okay. When the screen is moved 0.4 meter towards the slit, what happens? You have to you have to find it out. Of course, when the screen is moved 0.4 meter towards the slits, definitely the capital D will decrease and beta will decrease. Okay. Fringe width formula, you know. And now the first question, what is the first question? The distance between the central bright fringe and the fifth dark fringe. Okay. Fifth dark fringe, we have to find out 4.5 beta is given. What is 4.5 beta? That is 1.35 centimeters. Is it so? 4.5 beta is 1.35 centimeter. We will get what is beta. So beta is 4.5 here divided 1.35 centimeter divided by 4.5. Now you get the width of 1 beta, bright to bright fringe distance. So this is 3 times. And 0.3 into 10 to the power minus 2 centimeters. 10 to the power minus 2 meters. 0.3 centimeter is the distance between two successive bright fringes. So this is beta. Now once you get beta, you know capital D and small d. Why can't you find out lambda? So beta is equal to lambda d by d. 0.3 centimeters, that is the width of one fringe. Lambda, capital D is 1.4 meter away, right? 1.4 and 0.28 millimeter, yes. 0.28 distance between the sources. So 1.4 meter divided by 0.828 millimeter. Rearrange this, bring this 0.28 here, divide this by 1.4, it is 600 nanometer lambda. That is the wavelength. Because you know 1.4, 2 times, 14, 2 times 28. Now this is 0.2 times, 0.2 into 3, 0.06. Rest of the things, 600 nanometer. We have seen this problem yesterday, I know it. But still, don't neglect it. Suppose a problem, if you understand a problem, check it, you can check whether you can do that problem again after 2 days or 3 days. You will forget that problem. So it is not understanding difficult, it is keeping it fresh in your mind for a long time is difficult. So you have to remember that problem. You should know how the problem is solved, from where you have to start. That technique has to be remembered till the examination at least. So if you forget it, gone. Even if you have understood once, no use. So lambda is 600. Anything else asked in the problem? Also find the fringe width if the screen is moved 0.4 meter towards the slits. So if the screen is moved towards the slits here, D becomes D minus 0.4. D minus 0.4. That means 1.4 minus 0.4. Yesterday we have seen this. And now that is the capital D. So beta is equal to lambda capital D by D. Now the new fringe width is, this is 1, instead of 1.4 it is 1, 600 by 0.28. This is the fringe width, the new value 0.214 millimeters. So because this is minus 6 and the remaining is adjusted here, you check it, check the calculations later. So that is the new fringe width. Okay. Shall we move on to the next question? Yes. Light of wavelength 6000 angstrom is used to obtain interference fringes of width 6 millimeter, that means fringe width, interference fringes of width 6 millimeter in a Young's double slit experiment. That means 6 millimeter itself is the distance between two successive bright fringes or two successive dark fringes. It is very clear. Calculate the wavelength of light required to obtain the fringes of width 4 millimeter. If you want 6 millimeter, you have to use 6000 angstroms. In order to get a fringe width of 6 millimeter, that means the distance between the bright fringes has to decrease. That means you have to decrease lambda. Because for more lambda, you get more away bright fringes. If it is less lambda, then the fringes become closer and closer. Okay, calculate the wavelength of light required to obtain the fringes of width 4 millimeter. And when the distance between the screen and slits is reduced to half of its initial value, oh, they are reducing capital D also. Distance between the screen and the slits is also reduced to half. That means capital D must become D by 2. Lambda should become some other value so that 6 millimeter becomes 4 millimeter. However, you have to apply two equations. Well, we will use the first one now. Light of wavelength is used to obtain, and calculate the wavelength of light. Next wavelength is different. Now, can't you calculate small d, capital D here? You can do that. So, formula beta is equal to lambda D by D. Okay. Beta 6 millimeter. fringes, yeah, 6 millimeter. Lambda, 6,000 angstrom, 6,000 into 10 to the power minus 10. Capital D, don't know, small d, yes. Small d is 4 millimeter. So, this 4 millimeter can be, okay. Right. I have directly applied it now. This is the first equation, right? Now, the next equation is, what, I can bring this d here and 6 millimeter here later. Now, 4 millimeter is equal to, to obtain a fringe width of 4 millimeter. Right. Directly, I have written second equation. For 6 millimeter, I have 6,000 angstrom and capital D by D. For 4 millimeter, the new D should be D by 2, yes. Lambda, I don't know. Small d remains the same. That is not given. That is given, 4 millimeter. You can substitute it. Now, divide the two equations. That is better. All the things will get cancelled. The D, capital D, is distance between the screen and the sources has to be halved. What new wavelength will reduce the fringe width to 4 after 6? This D is remaining the same. Now divide it. 4 into 10 to the power minus 3 by 6. What happens here? Here lambda D by D. Here, of course, D by D will get cancelled. So here, what remains is lambda, capital D, by 2D. That is for 4 millimeter. What about for 6? 6,000. 10 to the power minus 10d by d. Hope you have followed this, right? 4 millimeter wavelength, fringe width, what is the lambda? If the distance, this one is hard. So, lambda d by 2d, that is as it is for 4 millimeter. For 6 millimeter, this is inverted. 6000 into 10 to the power minus 10 capital D by d. Capital D by d gets cancelled. So, what you will get? Lambda by 2 into 1 by 6000. Here, 4 by 6. So, solve this. Lambda is 8000. Angstroms, right? So, in order to obtain fringes of width 4 millimeter, actually you are in need of a lesser wavelength. But what happened is you have reduced the distance of capital D also. It is made half. So, what is the new wavelength? New wavelength is 8000 angstroms. Okay. Shall we move on to the next question? Hope you have followed this. Write the two conditions in the form of two equations. Then take the things which are common in both, they get cancelled. Remaining, you can do it. Okay. In Young's double slit experiment, fringes of certain width are produced on the screen, kept at a certain distance from the slits. Okay. So, okay, when the screen is moved away from the slits by 0.1 meter, so I am moving the screen by away. That means the new fringes, the new screen distance is 0.1 plus previous one. Suppose the previous one is capital D. The new distance is capital D plus 0.1. The fringe width changes by 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 meter. Here something is hidden. Fringe width changes by 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. What do you mean by changes by? It may be more than the previous value. It may be less than the previous value. Your marks have been changed by 20 marks. What is that? Your new marks may be 20 marks more than the previous value or less. Change means it is not mentioned clearly whether it is increase or decrease. But we have to conclude, because when the screen is moved away from the slit, that means capital D is increased. When capital D increases, fringe width increases. So, new fringe width is 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 plus the previous one, beta. Let the previous value be beta. Beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. Because the distance capital D has been increased when the screen is moved away from the slits, and no, nothing else is changed. That's why I can conclude here only the screen is moved away from the slits and nothing else, whether the distance between the sources changed, small d, no. Did they change the wavelength? No. Then only the question is, what is the separation between the slits is 1 millimeter, calculate the wavelength. Okay. In both experiments, the wavelength is same. The formula is beta is equal to lambda d by d. When d is increased by 0.1 meter, the fringe width also increases, because when d is made d plus 0.1, beta should become more. That means beta should become beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. Because they said fringe width changes by 6. That means that much you have to add. So, shall we write two equations? One is this one itself. The original values beta, lambda, capital D, small d. What is the new form of equation? Beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. See, this has to be written very properly in the exam. Sometimes they give the sentence directly saying that fringe width increases by 6 into 10 to the power minus 5, they say, then it is plus, right? Or fringe width increases to final value itself will be given. So you must be able to decode it in the exam under pressure. You will be under pressure in the exam, but still you must be very cool and you have to decode it. So beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 is equal to lambda capital D is D plus 0.1 because capital D is increased by 0.1. Sir, what we have to do with this equation? Shall we divide? Of course, if you divide it, I think what you are going to get now? Calculate the wavelength of light used. Okay. If you divide, lambda gets cancelled here. So better you subtract the equations. If divide, lambda get, lambda is the known value to be found out. So I will subtract the equations. Equation 1, equation 2. I will write it. The previous equations, I will write it again. Beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 here and d plus 0.1, everything else is common here. Beta equal to lambda d by d. So this minus this, what you will get? Beta plus 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 minus beta. And when you subtract these two, what I can, okay, I will write it. Lambda into d plus 0.1 by d minus lambda d by d, right? This one. So left hand side minus left hand side. Right hand side minus right hand side. You take lambda d plus 0.1 lambda by d. So you can spread it. 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. Beta minus beta got cancelled. Lambda by d. Lambda by d is common. Lambda by d is common. Correct? And what is here? D plus 0.1 minus d. Is it correct? Lambda by small d. D plus 0.1 minus capital D. Right? DD gets cancelled. So what the next equation? 6 into 10 to the power minus 5. Is equal to lambda by d into 0.1. Is it so? D is given, small d is given, 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters. So substitute this. So 1 into 10 to the power minus, lambda I have brought here, I have kept lambda here. So this into d is 6 into 10 to the power minus 5 into 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. This small d comes here, divided by 0.1. So this is 600 nanometer answer. Check it yourself. Check these calculations. I don't do that. It will be very childish then if I keep on substituting, explaining every step. But the major equation is this one. You must be able to write this, right? I am trying all the possible ways of problems, right? You may be in the final exam, you will be asked to find out simple beta, simple lambda like that. But we have to get ready with all tough type of problems. Because if you work out such type of tough problems, it becomes very easy to enter into the entrance exam problems. This is the basic for entrance exam questions. Okay, so fringe width increases by this one, that we have to conclude because they have given only changes by, since d increases from d to d plus 0.1. Suppose the d, capital D was decreased, I should have subtracted this from the original beta. Okay, then what else they want? So what, calculate the wavelength of light, suppression between, okay, that's all. That's all the problem. I think nothing is included here. I don't know. Next one. A beam of light consisting of two wavelengths, 500 nanometer and 400 nanometer, is used to obtain interference fringes in Young's double slit experiment. Oh, they are using two wavelengths. Actually, interference experiment has to be done with single wavelength, and that light has to be divided into two parts using two slits. Place that light in front of two slits, then the light coming out of the two slits will be from the same parent source, their coherent sources. Otherwise, we can't conclude if both the waves do not have the same wavelength and the same amplitude, we can't conclude where you get bright fringe, where you get dark fringe. So they should be identical. But they are using two sources, but they are switching on one by one and is used to obtain interference. Okay, Young's double slit experiment. The distance between the slits is 0.3, okay, millimeter, small d. And the distance between the slits and the screen is 1.5, capital D. Compute the least distance of the point from the central maximum where the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide. Yes. They are asking you, from the central fringe, where do you get the common fringes? Oh, I think you will not get an idea of this problem unless I show some pictures on this. So there are two sources, 400 nanometer and 500 nanometer. Very, very important problem. Just observe here. Once you solve the problem, you will get the answer. Suppose if I give you one more such type of problem, you can finish it within a minute. Only getting the idea is very important. These sentences must be converted into the mathematical form, and they must be applied into the diagram. Now, what is these sentences, sir? Okay, we have two sources. Both are switched on one by one. Distance between the slits, okay, capital D, small d, everything is given. Compute that from here onwards. Compute the least distance of the point from the central maximum where the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide. The question answer is only like this. You have two sources here, and here we have two bulbs. Switch on one bulb one after the other. Suppose it is a 400 nanometer and 500 nanometer. And one is larger wavelength, another is smaller wavelength. And you know that beta is equal to lambda d by d. If wavelength is more, beta is more. If lambda is more, beta is more. This is more wavelength. This is less wavelength. You know it. So if this is switched on and this is switched on, what we will do? First, we will switch on 400 nanometer. I will keep a bulb here of 400 nanometer. I will switch it on. Light from the 400 nanometer passes through the slits and identical waves travel and you get fringes. Of course, you know that central one should be a bright fringe. Say this 500 nanometer looks like blue, but it is not so. Maybe very close to blue. You get a bright blue because central fringe should be bright, whatever be the color. This is blue color now. What about next dark, next blue, bright, 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 like this way, right? So you will get bright blue fringes. This is zeroth blue fringe because central bright fringe is always bright. It has no dark fringe at the center. This is zeroth. This is the first bright blue, next bright blue, next bright blue, next bright blue. What is the number now? This is only an example I am explaining. This has nothing to do with the problem. Only the idea for the problem you have to take it from this, not the numericals. Not the numbers here, whatever I used to explain. This is first bright, second bright, third bright. Fourth bright of blue is formed here, right? 4 beta 1 I'll write. Which is beta 1 for us? Beta 1 is a smaller one in among them. That is 400 nanometer, this one. 400. 500 is not yet switched on. Okay? So this is 4 beta 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Central bright fringe should not be given a number. It should be 0. 1, 2, 3, 4 beta 1. Now I remove this blue light, switch on the red light, say 500 nanometer. Switch on the red light. 500 is not red, but still I'll take it as red. Central here should be red because when whatever be the type of the wave, by the time they meet here, crest falls on crest and it should be a bright. Red bright is produced. But next red bright is not against this blue. Can you tell me why? Next bright red is away from this blue because beta is equal to lambda d by d. And if lambda is less, beta is less. And if lambda is more, beta is also more. So the next red bright is far away from blue because its fringe width is more. Next dark, next bright red, next dark, next bright red. Now do they coincide here? See whether the first bright fringe of a zeroth bright fringe of blue and green are formed at the same place on the screen. What about the next bright fringe? Not coinciding. Next one, not coinciding. But here is something coinciding, right? Which fringes they are? They are the fourth bright fringes of blue and third bright fringe of red. They are formed at the same place. Can you imagine you and your friend walking on a road, right? Your foot length is 3/4 of a feet, right? 3/4 of a feet, not one full feet, 0.75 feet. Your friend's foot length is, he is very long and he is keeping larger steps, let us assume. He is having foot length of 1 foot. Now, whether your footsteps match? Yes, they match. When? When your friend covers 3 feet, say. He will be keeping 3 steps. But how many steps he will keep for 3 feet? For 3 feet you will keep. Your foot length is 0.75 feet. So 0.75 plus 0.75 is 1.5. 1.5 plus 1.5. That means 4 steps. When you keep 4 steps, you will be 3 meter away because your foot length is 0.75 feet. What about your friend? Your friend will keep exact third step at the same place. Did you get that? When your friend keeps 3 steps, 1 foot, 1 foot, 1 foot, 3 feet. When you keep 4 steps, 0.75, 0.75, 0.75, 0.75. your position and your friend's position will be at the same point. Similarly, here the lesser wavelength fringes are closer and closer. Higher wavelength fringes are away and away, but at one place they may coincide, because these fringes are very close. It is fourth fringe, and this one it's third fringe. They are formed at the same place. That means 4 beta 1 for blue must be equal to 3 beta 2 for red. That's all. Very simple analogy here. Now coming back to problem. Okay. That means in general you have to take. This is only a numerical taken to explain the problem. It need not be fourth bright fringe and third one itself. It may be fifth and seventh. It may be 10th and 15th. Any fringe may coincide. Of course, again, do they coincide, sir? Again, do they coincide? Yes. This is 8th fringe of blue and 6th fringe of red. Again, coincide. Sir, my friend and mine footsteps coincided at 3 meter and 4 meter. I kept 3 feet and 4 feet. I kept 4 feet distance. I walked 4 feet distance. My friend I walked 4 steps distance. 0.75, 0.75, 0.75, 0.75. It is 3 feet. My friend took only 3 steps to cover 3 meters. But our steps coincided. Now, do we coincide our steps again at some place? Yes, definitely. Your 8th step, your friend's 6th step coincides. You double everything. Your third step, your fourth step and friend's third step coincided. Next, friend's sixth one, yours eighth one. Similarly, here, the 8th fringe of blue and the 6th fringe of red, again they coincide. But we will find out the minimum distance. What is minimum distance? So, let the nth fringe of the first one and n2th fringe of the second one, let they be formed at the same place. For example, here, 4th fringe of blue, 3rd fringe of red are formed at the same place. If they are formed at the same place, from the central bright fringe, distance to that fringe is the same, right? X, I will say. Distance of that coinciding point from the central bright fringe must be same for both. That means 4 beta 1 must be equal to 3 beta 2, because these distances, they are formed at the same place. 4 beta 1. We will take that 4 and 3 in general way. N1 beta 1 must be equal to N2 beta 2. I don't know. The nth fringe of this one and the n2th fringe of this one. This is n1th fringe. This is n. Or n and m you can take anyway. So the nth fringe of this one and mth fringe of this one are formed at the same place. Or n1 beta 1 is equal to n2 beta 2. Now expand the beta 1 and beta 2. While explaining beta 1 and beta 2, you have to change wavelength. But not the capital D, small d, etc. Because both the wavelengths are using the same apparatus. So what I can write? N1, lambda 1 d by d is equal to N2, lambda 2 d by d. D by d is same. So cancel them. What you'll get? N1 lambda 1 is equal to N2 lambda 2. And if I continue it in the problem, then N1, I can finish it now. N1 lambda 1 d by d must be equal to N2 lambda 2 d by d. And capital D by d actually gets cancelled. But if you want, what is that? N1th and N2nd fringe, we have to find it out. Substitute the values. N1 lambda 1 500 nanometer into capital D by small d is equal to N2 400 nanometer into capital D by small d. These two things are same for both the wavelengths. They are using the same apparatus. So what you will get? N1 by N2. N2 you bring it here. 5 here. 4 by 5. Other things get cancelled. Now what do you mean by this one? Sir, can't I write it as 0.8? 4 by 5 is 0.8, sir. But here, see what is asked. Compute the least distance from the point from the central maximum, from the central brightest fringe, at what minimum distance where the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide. If you switch on 400 nanometer, you should get a bright fringe there. If you switch on 500 nanometer, you should get a bright fringe there. Numbers may be different. That means here the answer says that this should be a digit. And further, it should not be divisible by an integer. It should be a fraction. That means fourth fringe of N1, which is N1, this lambda 1, 500 nanometer. And fifth fringe of N2, what is N2? 400 nanometer. They are coinciding at the same place. You see, your foot length is 0.75 feet, correct? Your friend's foot length is 1 feet. So you have to keep 4 steps for 3 feet. If you want to cover 3 feet distance, you have to keep 4 steps. What about your friend? His foot length is more. So his number of steps may be less. Three steps will be enough to keep 3 feet distance. Similarly here, for 500 nanometer N1, less number of waves are enough because its wave beta fringe width itself is more. Where for 400 nanometer, more numbers are needed. So five fringes of 400 nanometer and 4 fringes of 500 nanometer are formed at the same place. That is what you have to conclude. Okay. This is what is my sentence. Let the N1th fringe of 500, N2th fringe of 400, let they be formed at the same point on the screen, say at a distance x from the central bright fringe. Then the same conclusion, N1 by N2 is 4 by 5. And now if you want, and I can show it here, right? This is N1, this is N2. And this should be made up of smaller wavelength because the fringes are closer and closer. This should be larger wavelength. But some N1th and N2th fringes are coinciding. So now their question is, so this part we have finished, N1 by N2 equal 4 by 5. Now what is the distance? That distance must be equal to 4 times the beta of smaller wavelength, correct? Or 5 times the beta of larger wavelength. Is it, 4 times the beta of smaller wavelength. Because, see, your foot length is 0.75 feet and your friend's is 1 foot. That means your friend's foot length is more, but he needs lesser steps. Whereas your foot length is less, you need more steps. You need more steps. Four fringes of 500 nanometer. And 5 fringes of 400 nanometer. 400 has to keep more and more steps. So, what is beta for each? You have to find out. X equal to N1 lambda d by d. N lambda d by d. Lambda d by d is fringe width, right? So, nth fringe is for 500 nanometer, it is 4 steps are enough. Because for 400 nanometer, 5 steps are needed. So, 500 nanometer divided by 0.3 into 10 to the power minus 3. Because they want the distance of that fringe. Anything you can do. If you are asked to find out the distance, either calculate 4 beta 1 or 3 beta 1. Here it is 4 and 5, isn't it? Here it is 4 and 5, yes. 4 and 5. Fourth fringe of 500 nanometer. N1 lambda d by d. N1 is fourth. This is the previous step. Yes. N1 is fourth. Lambda 1 is 500 nanometer into capital D by small d. That is, values are given. We have not used at N1 lambda 1 d by d. So that becomes 0.01 meter. Sir, can I calculate x in terms of other wavelength? Yes, possible. It is 5 steps or 5 bright fringes of 400 nanometers are also required. So you put 5 here, 400 here, rest of the things remain the same. You will get the same answer. You can try it. So at what minimum distance from the starting point, that is central bright fringe, will the two fringes coincide? This is how you have to do. Hope you have followed this. We have one more problem. There we will see this. This is another problem. You see, problem appears very long and horrible, but it is not at all horrible. It is very easy. Read the problem. Two beams of light having wavelengths 650 nanometer and 500 nanometer are used to eliminate interference slit one after the other. Distance between the slits and the screen is 60 centimeter, 0.6 meter, capital D. And distance of separation between the slits is 1 millimeter, small d. What is the distance of the third bright fringe on the screen from the central maximum for wavelength of 650 nanometer? If you use only this one, what is the distance of the third bright fringe? Of course, 3 beta. But for beta, lambda, this should be used. What is the distance between the third bright fringes of both? If both the fringes are, both the lights are switched on, what is the distance between the third fringes of both? Third fringe of 500 nanometer, third fringe of 650 nanometer. What is the distance between them? So you find out what is the 3 beta for this one, 3 beta for this one, subtract them. That's what you have to do. What is the least distance from the central fringe where the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide? This is what we were talking about in the previous problem. At the which point both the waves are, both fringes coincide? Of course, these answers are wrong. I have forgotten to remove this. It is in the book also. So these answers are wrong. I have to change it. Okay. Beta is equal to lambda d by d. We know it. this is the central bright fringe for blue, but the next blue is very close because lambda less, beta less. So next blue is very close. What about red? Next red is far away. Next red is far away. So where is the third bright fringe of blue? Blue bright, black. Again blue bright, black. Again blue bright. So here is the 3 beta 1 for the first blue fringe. What about the red fringe? Where is the third bright fringe of red? It's far away. 3 beta 2. Where beta 2 is lambda 2 by d by d. That is x2. What is the distance between this third bright fringe and this third bright fringe? That is the first question. What is the distance between the third bright fringes of both? So when you switch on blue light, you will get blue bright fringes. But they are closer and closer and closer. What about red fringes? They are far away, far away, far away. If you look into the previous explanation, here. What is the distance between third fringe of both? 1, 2, 3. This is the third bright fringe of blue. What is the third bright fringe of red? 1, 2, 3. Here. What is the distance between this third, red third and blue third? What is the distance between them? What you can do? Find out 3 beta for this, 3 beta for this, subtract, you will get the distance between the third bright fringes. That is the aim now. Okay, yes, this is over. No, right, that's over. Okay, so this is 3 beta 1 for blue. This is 3 beta 2 for red. What is the distance between the third bright fringe of this and this? 3 beta x2 minus x1. Suppose this distance is 7 millimeter, this is 3 millimeter. 4 millimeter is the distance from here to here. That is what you have to do. Now we will find out what is lambda 1 for the first color, because they have asked you what is the distance of the third bright fringe on the screen from the central maximum of 650 nanometer. Okay, beta is equal to lambda d by d. Beta 1 is lambda 1 d by d. Lambda 1 is 650 nanometer into 0.6 meters, capital D. Small d is something 1 millimeter. This is the next experiment, 520. So delete it now. So what is the answer for this one? This is equal to 390 micrometers. Because this is 0.6 into 650, that's all. This is 390 micrometers. Now, distance of the third bright fringe is, what you have to do? 3 beta, isn't it? Distance of the third bright fringe due to 500 nanometer. Sorry, 650 nanometer. 3 beta, 3 into 390 micrometers. That is 1170 micrometer. That is the distance of the third bright fringe from the central bright fringe. 1170 micrometers. That is for 650 nanometer. Sir, what about 520? Not yet switched on. Now the second bulb is getting switched on. It is little bit late, like a tube light. It is now getting switched on. 520, switch on 520. Of course, this is written in millimeter. Bring three places to the left, 1.17 millimeter. That you can do yourself. Yes, switch on 520 nanometer. What is beta for 520 nanometer? Beta 2 is lambda 2 d by d, 520 nano into d, capital D, 0.6 meter, 60 centimeter by small d, 1 millimeter. Now, what is beta 2? This is this comes to 312 micrometers or 0.312 millimeters. Now, what is the distance of the third bright fringe of 520 nanometer? 3 beta. 3 beta 2 is 3 into 312 into 10 to the power minus 6. That is 936 micrometer or 0.936 millimeter. We'll do that. 0.936 millimeter. So bring a minus 3 here. Remaining minus 3, you write it as 0.936 millimeter. Finished. Now, what is the distance between these two bright fringes? Suppose both the bulbs are switched on simultaneously. What is the distance between the third bright fringe of that lesser wavelength and third bright fringe of larger wavelength? Subtract them. You got x1, x2, x1 first, 1.17 millimeter. Now, x2 is the third bright fringe of this one, 0.936 millimeter. Subtract them. That is got, you will get the answer. X2, x1 is given. Subtract them. X2 minus x1. That is 1. Okay, this should be x1 minus x2, okay? Because this is far away, this is smaller. Far away is 650 nanometer third bright fringe. 520 nanometer third bright fringe will be closer. So x1 minus x2, please correct this. X1 minus x2 is 1.17 minus 0.936, 0.234 millimeter. So in the same way, you may be asked to find out what is the distance of the seventh dark fringe, 6 and half beta. 7 minus half beta, right? 6 and half beta. And what is the distance of the third bright fringe? What is the distance between them? Find out so many betas and find out the difference. That's all. Now we will move on to the next part of the question. What is the next part of the question? So we have answered many questions now. What is the distance of the third bright fringe on the screen? Okay, that is over. What is the distance between the third bright fringes of both? That is also over. What is the least distance from the central bright fringe where the bright fringes due to both the wavelengths coincide? If you switch on 650 nanometer, if you switch on 50 nanometer, both should produce. Both should produce the same. Both the waves should produce a bright fringe at the same place. Yes. Somewhere I have gone wrong. I have doubt. Yeah. Right. This is over. And it is 650. Oh, there were somewhere I have taken wrong. Yes. It is 500 here. It should be 520. Okay. This should be 520. That's what I was guessing about here. How it came different. So, 650, this is 520. You see, in the next case, it is 520. Yes, 520. And okay, beta 1 is over. Beta 2 is 3 beta 1 is over. 3 beta 2 is over. Everywhere we have used 520. We will take it as it is. Now, distance between the two bright fringes is also over. Third bright fringe. Now, the coinciding point. Again, the same process. At the central bright fringe, you should have a one wavelength. And then dark, bright, dark, bright, dark, bright. Of course, it continues. Zeroth, first one, second one, third dark fringe, bright fringe is produced. Okay, dark, bright, yes. Fourth bright fringe. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what about this is 4 beta 1. What about another switch on another light? It's the lambda is more. Beta is more. So, fringes are far away. Yes, next bright. Dark, bright, dark, bright, dark, bright. Bright, bright coincide. But this is the fourth bright and this is the third bright. Don't name the central bright, right? Third bright, 3 beta 2. So, N1 beta 1 must be equal to N2 beta 2. This is only a numerical data just for understanding. May not be fourth and third itself. Last time we got fourth and fifth, right? So, N1 beta 1 must be equal to N2 beta 2. N1 lambda 1 d by d must be equal to N2 lambda d by d, lambda 2 d by d. D by d, of course, same for both because they are using the same apparatus. Then N1 lambda 1 is equal to N2 lambda 2. Next N1 by N2 is equal to lambda 2 by lambda 1. N1 by N2 is equal to lambda 2 520 by 650. 52 by 65 is the ratio. You don't, sir, doesn't it get divided? You get a fraction. See what conclusion you are going to get. Last time we got 5 by 4, right? 4 by 5. I was saying that you could have written it as 0.8. If you are writing it as 0.8, what you will say finally? It is the 0.8th fringe of both coincide. No. It should be an integer, right? It is the fifth fringe of one wavelength and the fourth fringe of another wavelength are coinciding at the same place. Understood? Similarly, 52nd fringe of N1. What is N1? 520. 52nd. What are the wavelengths? I have forgotten the problem. The wavelengths are 650 and 520. Okay. Remember it. 650 and 520. Oh, it is here only. 650 and 520. I am just okay. 650 and 520. Yeah, it is here only. 52nd fringe of 650. It is not 520. Because for 650 nanometer, larger steps friend, right? Friend keeping larger steps. He needs lesser number of steps. What about 520? Needs more number of steps. Got it? So, 52nd fringe of 650 nanometer and 65th fringe of 520 nanometer are formed at the same place. For 520 nanometer lesser wavelength, more steps are required. Understood? So, suppose the answer, last time answer was 4 by 5. It was the fourth fringe of larger wavelength, fifth fringe of smaller wavelength, right? If you have kept 4 steps, then it is your foot length is less. If your friend has kept only 3 steps, your friend's foot length should be more. That's all. Very simple conclusion. 52nd bright fringe of 650 nanometer, 65th bright fringe of 520 nanometer are formed at the same place. Okay, so 52nd of 650, 65th of 520 are formed at the same place, and what is the distance of that fringe? Of course, this is only numerical example. 52nd into 0.390 millimeter, because it's a 52nd bright fringe of 390, bright fringe of which one? It is 520 nanometer. So when you use 520 nanometer, what beta you have got? Okay, I have to go back. What beta you have got when you used 520 nanometer? 312. This you have to use for 52nd. 312 micrometers, 52nd bright fringe of 0.39. Right? Did I get 390? What did I say? Forgotten? 52nd bright fringe of 520. When you use 520, you got a fringe width of 312. Okay. 52nd bright fringe of 52nd for 650 nanometer, right? Because it is smaller in size. What is 650 nanometer? 52nd bright fringe of 650 nanometer. For 650 nanometer, 390 micrometer. So 52nd into 390. Did I do that? 52nd into 390. 52nd into, 390 millimeter. That is 20.28 millimeter. What about the distance of the 65th bright fringe of another one? Lesser wavelength. Because for 65th steps, lesser lambda is, lesser beta is enough. So 65th of 0.312 millimeter are formed at the same place. You see, you get the same answer for both, right? Last time it was the fourth bright fringe of smaller wavelength. Fourth bright fringe of larger wavelength. Fifth bright fringe of smaller wavelengths are formed at the same place. You multiply that's betas. 52nd beta of 650 nanometer, that is 390 millimeter fringe width. 65th bright fringe of 520 nanometer, that is 0.312 meter millimeter fringe width. They are formed at the same place, 20.8 millimeter from the central bright fringe. So that is what you have to do. Hope you have followed it. I struggled a little bit to explain in between because I am getting sleep at the same time I am explaining. It is too late to now. But still, I think you can follow this up. But we will solve a few more problems, then you can understand. For the timing, we will stop it here. Next time, we will meet with the diffraction, another property of light, which is very close to that interference. Huygens wave theory is applicable in diffraction also. What do you mean by diffraction of light? And how can you see in your day-to-day life, diffraction? Where you can see? And what is actually happening in diffraction? What does it finally yield? And what special things you see in this nature due to diffraction? We will see that. A little bit of theory is also in used. But once you have followed interference, you can follow diffraction. And then we have one more property, very easy property called polarization of light. That completes that chapter, but needs a few days. So hope you have followed this problem and try to get that. Actually, the links here here are very easy in links. Once you understand what are the fringe widths and where are the distances, it is easy. But try to solve these problems again. And if you want, I will explain this final last problem once again in the next class when I am in a fresh mood. From today onwards, I need not have to prepare for SSLC classes. So I get a little more time. I can add few more colors into this and I can have special animations and I can show it to you. From today, tomorrow onwards, I have to maintain this theory class and CET class. That's all. Only two classes per day. So I need not worry. Otherwise, I will have to engage four to five classes per day. That was hectic. So we will discuss this again in the next class. If you have any doubts, then we'll move forward. So thanks for watching. Thanks for understanding all these things. And it will help you a lot. We are spending a little bit of time for all these things so that you will understand everything. And that will help you in future. Hope you are making the best use of this. We will meet in the next class. Till then, have a nice time. Thanks for watching.